We sign ourselves in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today the Church honors St. Charles Lwanga and 21 companions who were martyred for the faith during the years 1885 to 1887 in Uganda. And their manner of death was by the sword or by being burned to death. They were all catechists and were teaching the faith to other people. So today the Church remembers St. Charles Lwanga and 21 companions. We gather together this morning to hear God's word and to share this table of sacrifice. Lord Jesus, you healed the sick. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you forgave sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you gave yourself to heal us and bring us strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who have made the blood of martyrs the seed of Christians, mercifully grant that the field which is your church, watered by the blood shed by St. Charles Lwanga and his companions, may be fertile and always yield you an abundant harvest. This we pray through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Not according to our works, but according to his own design.
Some Sadducees, who say there is no resurrection, came to Jesus and put this question to him, saying, "Teacher, Moses wrote for us, if someone's brother dies, leaving a wife and no child, his brother must take the wife and raise up descendants for his brother. Now there were seven brothers. The first married a woman and died, leaving no descendants. So the second brother married her and died, leaving no descendants. And the third, likewise. And the seven left no descendants. Last of all, the woman died. At the resurrection, when they arise, whose wife will she be? For all seven have been married to her." Jesus said to the Sadducees, "Are you not misled because you do not know the scriptures or the power of God? When they rise from the dead, they neither marry nor are given in marriage, but they are like the angels in heaven. As for the dead being raised, have you not read in the book of Moses, in the passage about the bush, how God told Moses, 'I am the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob'? He is not God of the dead, but of the living. You are greatly misled." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
To truly master something requires understanding the general operating principle, why and how something works. For example, you can mix the ingredients as specified in the cookbook and come up with a dish that is at least edible. But a real chef learned how different ingredients work together. The most effective techniques of chopping, kneading, and whisking, and how to get the most out of the kitchen itself, including the appliances, utensils, and cookery. In today's gospel, Jesus' questioners, the Sadducees, don't get the general operating principle. They know the intricacies of God's law, but they can't grasp the spirit of compassion and justice that is at the heart of the law. They devise a hypothetical situation in order to trap Jesus into making a legal determination. But Jesus focuses instead on the general operating principle, and that is the love of God that brings a couple together in this life and unites all to God in the next. It's easy to become anxious about the details, the regulations, the recipes, and formulas that make our lives function. But Jesus urges us to keep in mind God's general operating principle, which is that compassion and mercy, justice and peace are at the heart of what it means to be fully human, to be alive in this life, and to be alive in the next. Recognizing that God always works for goodness beyond our imagination, we bring our needs to Him. For the church, may God empower us and contribute to the transformation of the whole world, we pray to the Lord. For governments around the world, may God guide their leaders to the truth, especially the truth of dignity of every human person. We pray. for the intentions that we bring to this Eucharist. We pray to the Lord. For all those who have died in the hope of resurrection, may they rest in the peace of God's love. We pray to the Lord. God of infinite goodness, hear our prayers today. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice for the hands of the praise of the Lord's name, for our good and the cause of the Holy Church.
Lord, we offer you sacrifice, humbly praying that, as you granted the blessed martyrs, Charles and companions, grace to die rather than sin, so you may bring us to minister at your altar in dedication to you alone. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up
and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the blood of your blessed martyrs, Charles and companions, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear your witness through your Son, Jesus Christ. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim. Holy, 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 heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time Jesus was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving his Father thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and giving his Father thanks, he gave it to his disciples. disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Holy Father, Donald, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, and with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and Saint Charles and companions, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May what helped them to endure torment make us, in the face of trials, steadfast in faith and in charity. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be